Hi everyone, my name is Ravi Prakash and welcome to fourth class of time and distance, okay? Again, we'll start with this beautiful question here, okay? So don't treat like a story, okay? You may get carried away, okay? It's a simple question, thing like that, okay? And it's look like a big question, right? But it's a very good concept and you can solve it within 1 minute, okay? Let's know this concept now. A father drops his daughter daily from his home to school by car, okay? So again, while making this, reading this kind of question, as we have done in last question also, just make this diagram. Diagram is very important, right? Diagram is very important, okay? So father drops his daughter from, let's say this is the home and this is the school of daughter, right? So father drops his daughter daily from his home to school by car. He leaves his home by 4 p.m., reaches his school, picks the daughter and comes back home by 6 p.m., wasting no time, okay? That means he leaves the home by 4 p.m., reaches the school, picks the daughter and comes back by 6 p.m., wasting no time, okay? Okay, so wasting no time, okay? She reaches here at 6 p.m., he reaches here at 6 p.m., fine. Now, so obviously if it is wasting no time, that means when he left his school, when he left at 4 p.m., so he must have reached his school by 5 p.m., okay? So he reaches school by 5 p.m., right? This is the meaning of wasting no time. Because home to school distance is same. So 2 hours for total to and fro. That means 1 hour for going and 1 hour for coming. Fine? Okay. Now, school closes at 5 p.m. also. Fine. So school closes at 5 p.m. and he reaches also at 5 p.m. So both are coinciding. Fine. Now, after this. But one day, his school was closed an hour early. But that day, okay, I'm talking about that day now. So, okay, so we'll draw a black one. So, that day, school closed by 4 p.m., okay. Then, his daughter started walking towards her home, okay. The father, unaware of this, leaves his home as usual, but meets his daughter on the way, okay. So, again, father, again leaves his home at 4 p.m. Okay. So, father again leaves his home at 4 p.m. But some way in the middle, meets his daughter. Okay. So, let's say his daughter traveled this distance, right? So, he meets his daughter here and comes back his home. Okay. Comes back his home by what? By 5:45 p.m. Okay. So, due to this daughter traveling this distance, okay, due to that daughter traveled this distance, he could save his 15 minutes time. Because earlier he used to reach at 6 p.m. But today he reached at 5:45 p.m., right? So, he saved 15 minutes time. So, obviously, he will save that 15 minute time. How? 7.5 in the forward direction and 7.5 in the backward direction, right? That means total, he has saved 15 minutes time, right? That means he has saved 7.5 minutes each side, okay? That means he was supposed to reach school at 5 p.m. He was supposed to reach school at 5 p.m., but he saved 7.5 minutes time. So, he will reach this point. He will reach this point at what time? At 4:52.5. That means 4 hour, 52 minute and 30 second. Correct. He will reach here at 4:52.5. That, okay? He saved 7.5 minutes on each side because it saved 15 minutes in total. To and fro total. That means 7.5, 7.5 both side. 7.5, 7.5 both side. Okay. So, he used to reach school at 5 p.m. But he saved his 7.5 minutes time and he reached this point here at 4:52.5 minutes. Okay. So, now, how to compare the ratio of, to find the ratio of speed of father's car to speed of daughter. Okay. So, how to find it? How to find this part? Speed of father's car to speed of daughter. How to find this part? So, I know the only part in the whole diagram which daughter traveled is this part. So, only in this part, I can compare his speed of, only in this part, I can compare his speed of father and his speed of daughter. Only in this part, I can compare his speed of father's car and daughter's walking speed, right? So, see, Again, this distance is constant. So this distance and this distance I'm talking about, this distance, let it be d. Only this distance, right? This distance has been traveled by daughter in how much time? So that day school was closed an hour early. So school was closed at 4 p.m. The daughter reached here at 4:52.5. So this distance d is covered by daughter in 52.5 minutes. Okay, because father reaches here at 4:52.5 and picks his daughter. And daughter started walking right at 4 p.m. Okay, when the school was closed. That means daughter kept walking for 52.5 minutes. Okay, so D distance is covered by daughter in 52.5 minutes. And D distance will be covered by father in how much time? So father used to reach school at 5 p.m. But this point he reached at 4:52.5 p.m. Saving how much? 7.5 minutes, right? That means this distance would be traveled by father in how much time? 7.5 minutes. 7.5 minutes, right? So this distance D is traveled by father in how much time? 7.5 minutes. Okay. So what is time ratio? So ratio of time taken by daughter to time taken by father is how much? 52.5:7.5. You can cancel it. It will be 7:1. Okay. And since distance is constant, so speed is inversely proportional with time. That means what is speed of daughter to speed of father? It's just reverse. 7:1, so reverse. 1/7:1/1, that is 1:7. This is the answer for this question. Beautiful question. So speed of daughter to speed of father, what is the ratio? It is 1:7. Okay, I hope it is fine. Okay, so the answer is what? 1:7. Okay, now move to next question. Okay, so this is the next question here. A hunter fired 2 shots from his gun at an interval of 76 seconds. A tiger running away very fast hears the 2 sounds at an interval of 83 seconds. Okay. So, speed of sound is 332 meter per second. Find speed of tiger. Super question. It's a super question. Okay. Now, understand this concept here. A hunter fired 2 shots from his gun at an interval of 76 seconds. Right. So, see. Let's say hunter is firing first sound. Understand the concept very carefully. T second, and it is now T plus 76 second, right? The interval first sound has been fired at, let's say, T second, and the second sound after an interval of 76 second, right? That means at an interval of 76 second, that means second sound is at T plus 76. So a tiger running away very fast hears the 2 sounds at an interval of 83 second, right? So let's say tiger is somewhere here initially, okay? So it doesn't matter here, right, that tiger is how close to hunter. Let's say hunter is here, okay. So it doesn't matter that tiger is very close to hunter, tiger is very far from hunter. No issue, right? Because whatever is the position of tiger here, some time will sound take to reach from here to here, okay. Same time sound will take in the second time also to reach from here to here. So time will be obviously same, right? Suppose you are standing here right now and 2 kilometers farther from you, or at a distance of 2 kilometers from you, a gun is fired. So that you won't hear that sound instantaneously, right? It will take a bit of time for sound to travel from that point to this point. Okay, to travel a distance of 2 kilometers, because sound travels at a speed of around 330 meter per second. In this question, it is 332 meter per second. Okay, so it takes a bit of time for sound to travel at distance, right? So at 332 meter per second, that means around 3 seconds to travel 1 kilometer. Okay, sound takes, right? It takes a bit of time. It can't be instant, right? A gun is fired 2 kilometers from here and you hear that sound instantaneously, right? It will take around 6 to 7 seconds for sound to reach to your place, okay? If it is fired 2 kilometers away. So same here also. So sometime sound will take to reach from this point to this point, okay? So tiger at this point hears the first sound. Okay, fine. So tiger hears the first sound at this point. Okay. Market X. Let's say tiger hears the first sound at X second. Now tiger kept running. Okay. Let's say tiger hears the second sound here. and tiger hears a second sound at x plus 83 seconds. Okay, because tiger hears a two sounds at an interval of 83 seconds, right? So see, if tiger was standing here, tiger would hear the first sound at x seconds. Okay, let's say time is x seconds for sound to reach from here to here. So at some x time or in x seconds, time reaches sound reaches from here to here. Okay, so if tiger is standing here only, so tiger would hear the time first sound at x seconds, and second time if tiger was standing here only, then second sound tiger would have heard at after x plus 76 seconds, because again the time interval would be same. Okay, time interval would be same. Okay, suppose same thing, I'll tell you, a gun is fired 2 kilometers away from your house, okay, and another gun is fired after 30 minutes. Okay, so you, if you are at your home only, so if 2 kilometers away, interval of two sounds is 30 minutes, interval of two shots fired is 30 minutes, then you would also hear the distance, the interval of two sounds at 30 minutes only, right? That means the time interval would be same, obviously, right? Because time takes in both the cases, sound will take same time to travel from that point to this point. Okay, so here also, if tiger was standing here only, so he would hear the first sound at x second and second sound at x plus 76 second. But due to he kept running, so he heard the second sound at x plus 83 second. So this distance is covered by sound as well as tiger, because I have to compare speeds of sound and tiger. So I have to take a case where a distance I have to take which is covered by both sound and tiger, right? Like in last question, a distance I need to compare between for father and daughter, a distance which is traveled by both father and daughter, that distance I need to compare. Okay, so covered by sound as well as tiger. So this distance is covered by sound as well as tiger. Okay, now this distance d is covered by tiger. Distance d is covered by tiger. And how much time? First sound he heard at x second, first sound he heard at x second or x time, and second sound he heard at x plus 83. That means tiger kept running for 83 seconds, right? So distance d is covered by tiger in 83 seconds. Same distance d is covered by sound in how much time? Is covered by sound in how much time? So sound reaches here where tiger was first standing. So sound reaches here at x plus 76 and sound reaches here at x plus 83. That means this distance has been covered by sound in how much time? In 7 seconds. X plus 76 to x plus 83, 7 seconds, right? So this distance d is covered by sound in 7 seconds. Okay, so again distance is constant. So if distance is constant, speed is inversely proportional to time. Okay, so I can directly write it now. I don't need to write inverse ratio. S is inversely proportional to t. That means s1 by s2 is equal to t2 by t1. Okay, if I compare this to, we studied this in proportion variation, right? This thing. So s1 by s2 equal to t2 by t1. Okay, so now what is s1 here? So here in this case, let's say speed of tiger, I take s1 as st, speed of tiger to speed of sound I take. Okay, that ratio is better to write. So right here, speed of tiger to speed of sound to time of sound to time of tiger, right? Ratio is inverse, no? So can't be equal. Tiger is in numerator, so tiger will be in denominator here, time of tiger, right? What is speed of tiger? I have to calculate speed of tiger. Okay, so I have to calculate speed of tiger here. Fine. Speed of tiger I have to calculate upon speed of sound, that is 332. Time taken by sound is how much? 7. Time taken by tiger is how much? 83. That's it. Therefore, you get ST as how much? 83 cancels 4 times. So, 4, 7, 28. 83 into 4 is 332. What is speed of tiger? 28 meter per second. So, 28 meter per second is the answer for this beautiful question. 28 meter per second. 28 meter per second is the answer for this very nice question and very wild question. Wild because it contains tiger, right? Okay, so this is a concept behind it, correct? So same thing here, nice concept it is. Two similar problems were discussed, same for father and daughter and for the sound and tiger. Okay, father and daughter in the last question and sound and tiger in this question, right? So we have to compare his speeds and all, right? So it should be like, I have to take a particular distance which is covered by both the persons, right? Then only I can compare his speed. Like here, sound and tiger, this distance D is compared, right? In last question, the distance which daughter walked, same distance can be compared for speed of father and speed of daughter, right? To find that particular distance there, okay? Now move to next question. Okay, now go to some easy questions but different concept, right? Easy question but different. These questions were okay, fine for distance constant, speed is inversely proportional to time, but now some different concepts will do, okay? Now see this question here. Two cyclists cover the same distance at 15 km per hour and 16 km per hour respectively. Find the distance traveled by each if one takes 16 minutes longer than the other. Okay, now again two methods I'll discuss for this question. Again two methods to make you think in different directions. Okay, first method, since distance is constant here, so again speed is inversely proportional to time for both the cyclist. Okay, so their speed ratio, let's say s1 is to s2, it is 15 is to 16, correct? Speed ratio, therefore their time ratio would be what? Inverse of this, that is 1/15 is to 1/16, that is 16 is to 15. Okay, now the distance traveled by each if one takes 16 minutes longer than the other. So this guy, first one, is getting 16 units time, ratio is 16 and his ratio is 15, right? What is the difference in ratio of 1 unit? So that means this ratio difference of 1 unit corresponds to 16 minutes in the question. Therefore ratio difference of 16, therefore 16 units is how much? 16 minutes into 16, that is 256 minutes. Okay, 256 minutes. Okay, that means this first one is 256 minutes, so directly I can do this. 1 unit is 16 minutes, that means 16 minutes is what? 16 into 16, that is 256 minutes. And what is 15 units? 15 into 16, that is 240 minutes. This is easy, right? Because 240 minutes directly means 4 hours. Okay, so what is distance? Distance is speed into time. So speed, I can take this speed, right? So if this is speed, this time, it is t2 of 15 corresponds to speed of 16, corresponds to speed of this t2 of 15 corresponds to speed of how much? This corresponds to speed of what? 16, right? Because second speed to this ratio of first speed, right? So S2 corresponds to T2. So this speed of 16 km per hour corresponds to 15 minutes. Okay. Because time is inverse, no? Okay. So 240 minutes, 4 hours. So distance is speed into time. What is the speed here? So let's say speed, I take this one, 16 km per hour. Because there's nothing like it. I can take this also. I can take 256 and 15 also, right? But this is not in decimal, right? This is in like decimal when you convert to hours. So this is like perfect hour, 4 hour integer figure. So easy to do. That's it. 16 into 4. That is 64 kilometers is the answer for this question. Correct? Fine. Second method. Okay. Now, find the distance traveled by each if one takes 16 minutes longer than the other, right? Again, this question can be done by taking is distance as LCM of speed. So we did this concept, okay? Distance as LCM of speed, right? That is LCM of 15 and 16. So since 15 and 16 have nothing in common, so what is their LCM? Full 15 into 16, that is 240 kilometer. So I'll assume distance as 240 kilometer, but what does that mean? If distance is 240 kilometer, so in first case, time taken at 15 km per hour will be how much? 240 by 15, that is 16 hours. And in the second case, time taken at 16 kilometer per hour will be how much? Time is distance by speed. 240 by 16, that is 240 by 16, that is 15 hours. So according to question, this according to this assumed data, if distance assumed is 240 kilometer, okay, then difference in time is how much? Difference in time is 60 minutes, right? Difference in time is 60 minutes. Okay, 1 hour has been 60 minutes. Okay, that means if difference in time is 60 minutes, then distance is 240 kilometer. Okay, what is my difference in time? 16 minutes, right? Actually, it is how much? 16 minutes. So if difference in time is 1 minute, distance should be how much? 240 by 60, that is 4 kilometer. So if difference in time is how much? 16 minutes. Actually, it is 16 minutes. Actually, what the distance should be? 4 into 16, that is 64 kilometer. That's what you got in the last method also, same answer, right? What is the answer? 64 kilometer, right? So this is very easy method actually, right? We'll use it in a lot of places. Just assume distance to be the LCM of speeds, so that the time you get as integers. When you get time as integers, you can directly compare with the question. If this is the difference in time, this is the speed, or this is the distance, right? So if the actual time is this, so what is the actual distance? You can get in that ratio, okay? So this is the answer for this question. Fine, move to next question. Okay, now we'll discuss a concept here, not a question here. We'll discuss a concept. Okay, the concept is of average speed. Okay, the concept is of average speed. Now, what is average speed? So, average speed is basically what? Average speed is total distance, right? Total distance upon total time. Total distance upon total time. This is the average speed, right? Total distance upon total time is the average speed. Okay. So we'll discuss few cases here of average speed to understand it better. Okay. Let's say first case we'll discuss when distances are covered in equal parts. Okay, that means let's say for example a person is going from point A to point B. So he is going from point A to point B. Okay, what he is doing is going from point A to point B and then returning from point B to point A, right? So like suppose it's going at the speed of A kilometer per hour and is coming at the speed of B kilometer per hour. So what is the average speed in this case? So in this case, the average speed is how much? Total distance by total time. So let's assume that AB, the distance is equal to D, right? The distance, how much? The distance is D here. Okay, so D. So what is average speed? Total distance, that is 2D, upon total time. What is total time taken here? So time taken for first case is how much? What is time? Distance by speed. So time is always distance by speed. Okay, so distance is D here and speed is A, plus time for coming back, again distance of D at the speed of B. Okay, so you can see it, 2D upon, you can take D as common, right? 1 by A plus 1 by B. This DD cancels here. Okay, that is, you get 2AB by A plus B. Any point funda actually, it is right. 2AB by A plus B. Okay. So what I'm trying to discuss, right? Few very important points here. Okay. So average speed, basically, you can see here, when distance were covered in equal part, right? That means it doesn't matter here. If I say first part is D and again second part is D, right? So distance are covered in the speed of, let's say first part is covered at A kilometer per hour and second part is covered at B kilometer per hour. So it doesn't matter, right? What you got here as, you solved it. So what you got average speed? So you got average speed as 2 upon, right? You actually got 2D upon D by A plus D by B. This case is same as the last case, right? I told you when distances are covered in equal parts, right? That means basically distance are covered in equal parts. So in that case, the same thing also, no, going back and returning, right? So distance, both are equal. Here also same thing, distance is equal in two parts, right? So both these cases are same. Okay, so it is actually dd gets cancelled here, dd gets cancelled here. What do you get? 2 by 1 by a plus 1 by b. Okay, now get hold this concept here. Okay, similarly, if you see distance in three parts, okay, d, this is also d, and this is also d. So distance are covered in three parts. First part at the speed of a kilometer per hour, second part at the speed of b kilometer per hour, and third part at the speed of c kilometer per hour. So what is the average speed here? You get 3d upon d by a plus d by b plus d by c. Again, d will take common, you can cancel it. What do you get? You get 3 by 1 by a plus 1 by b plus 1 by c. Okay, so this is called harmonic mean. This is called harmonic mean. Okay, what is harmonic mean here? See, so this is harmonic mean. What is harmonic mean? Because harmonic mean is basically, it comes from harmonic progression. So it basically means that if A, B, C are in AP, okay, that is in arithmetic progression. So B is always A plus C by 2. Okay, so B is always A plus C by 2. So it means that if A, B, C are in AP, so it means that, now if I write here, if A, B, C are in HP, if A, B, C are in HP, okay, it means that 1 by A, 1 by B and 1 by C are in AP. That is the meaning of HP, harmonic progression. That's as simple as this, right? If A, B, C are in AP, that is arithmetic progression, then 1 by A, 1 by B and 1 by C are in AP. Okay, so that means, what is the arithmetic mean? So that means arithmetic mean is always inverse of harmonic mean, or HP is always inverse of AP. HP is always inverse of AP, right? Or I can write here in this case, see. So what is their harmonic mean now? So their harmonic mean comes out to be, so their arithmetic mean first, what it is? So arithmetic mean is 1 by B is equal to 1 by A plus 1 by C by 2. So what is the harmonic mean now? It is inverse of it, right? That is B is equal to 2 by 1 by A plus 1 by C. See, can find the relation here, from here to here, same thing, right? 2 by 1 by A plus 1 by C. That basically means that, what is harmonic mean of three things? Okay, so harmonic mean of three things is always like the middle thing, that is, here is the average speed, right? It's always 2 by 1 by A plus 1 by B, right? So when distances are covered, that means I can say, so here A and B are in harmonic progression. That is harmonic, I calculating what harmonic mean here. Because we solved it, and we solved it, you get 2AC by 1 plus C, A plus C. In last slide, we solved it, this part, and we got 2AB upon A plus B, we got, right? 2AB upon A plus B. So, when distances are covered in equal parts, then speeds are in harmonic progression. That's it. Okay, speeds are in harmonic progression. Okay, so I should write this statement here. Let me rub this. I just write all this fun I'm discussing here. Just sit back and enjoy when you're studying it, and work really hard when you're practicing the question. Okay, every concept we'll discuss one by one. Okay, I'm writing here, if distances are covered in equal parts, okay, if distances are covered in equal parts, then average speed, right? So I can write for calculating average speed here, or I can basically write, then speeds are in harmonic progression. Harmonic progression, right? Then that means average speed, right? I can directly write right now, like write like this. Okay, that if, like this, right? Distance here is d, distance again here is d, distance again here is d. It going on, right? Four parts. First part covered at a speed of 8 kilometer per hour. Second part covered at a speed of b kilometer per hour. Third part at this per c kilometer per hour, and fourth part at d kilometer per hour. Okay, then what is average speed? Average speed is the harmonic mean of all the speeds, right? Average speed is the harmonic mean of all the speeds. That is 4 by 1 by a plus 1 by b plus 1 by c plus 1 by d, right? So 2 by 1 by a plus 1 by b, 3 by 1 by a plus 1 by b plus 1 by c, 4 by 1 by a plus 1 by b plus 1 by c plus 1 by d. This is the average speed. Okay, then speed sign harmonic progression. Okay, or I can write here for more clarity. You can change the statement here. Then you can write here, then average speed I can write. Okay, that's for better clarification. Then average speed is the harmonic mean of these speeds. That will be the more easier one. Okay, average speed is the harmonic mean of the speeds. Okay, so we'll discuss this concept in the next video, right? Very important concept, right? Continue in next video, this one. Okay, thank you.